Hello students, welcome to the fun zone. Today we are going to study 2D shape and its area and perimeter. Specifically, we are going to study quadrilaterals, the type of quadrilaterals and parallelogram. So let us understand students, what is a quadrilateral and what are its types. A quadrilateral has, so students, here there are some pointers which you have to keep in mind. So whenever if someone is telling ki this figure is a quadrilateral, if someone is telling this figure is a quadrilateral, so you have to check that pointers. If the figure has four sides, the quadrilateral have four sides. That means if that figure have four sides, which is also called as edges, then we can call that figure as a quadrilateral. If that figure has four vertex, that means four corners, then we can call that figure as a quadrilateral. And if the interior angle, if we are adding all the interior angle of that figure and together that interior angle is 360 degree, then we can call the figure as quadrilateral. So in all, I can say that if a figure have four sides, have four vertices, and together, if we are going to add the degrees of interior angle of that figure, and we are going to get 360 degrees, then we can call that figure as a quadrilateral. Let us see how the quadrilateral looks. Yes, you can see over here, students, here figure number one, you can see there are four sides, side number one, two, 3 and 4. Yes, this figure has four sides. That means this figure has four edges. Is this figure have four vertices? That means corners. Yes, I can see corner number 1, 2, 3, 4. So yes, even our second condition is satisfied over here, that this figure has four corners. Now our last condition, interior angle has to be added and it has to be 360 degree. Let us add and see, students. The first angle is 68, then is 118, then it is 94, and then it is 80. So if we'll see 68 degrees plus 118 degrees plus 94 degrees plus 80 degrees, you are getting answer 360 degrees, students. So just because figure number one is satisfying all our three conditions, condition number A, condition number B, and condition number C, we can say figure number one is a quadrilateral. Now students, let's go to figure number two. You can see figure number two over there. Now let us check, does it satisfy all our conditions or not of being a quadrilateral or not? Check, does this figure have four sides? Yes, I can see, right? Side number 1, 2, 3 and 4 means yes, this figure has four sides. Does this figure have four vertices? Check out, students. Yes, what is this number 1, 2, 3, 4? These are four corners. That means you can call, yes, it has four vertices. Thus, if you will add all the angles of the figure or the interior angles of the figure, are you getting 360 degrees? That we will check, students. Now, one angle is of 90 degree, another 90, another 90 and 90. That means we'll be doing 90 plus 90 plus 90 plus 90. Either doing this 90 plus 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 4 times, like 90 plus 90 plus 90 plus 90. We can, rather than writing the whole thing, we can just write 4 into 90, which will be also giving us the same answer, that is 360 degrees. And as the interior angles, when added up, it gives the answer as 360 degrees. We call, students, this figure number 2 is a quadrilateral because it is satisfying all our criteria of four edges, four vertices and 360 degree. Now students, let us understand what are types of quadrilaterals. You must be thinking, types of quadrilateral, what they are? Students, you can see over here, there are five different types of quadrilaterals. First is rectangle, second is square, third is a rhombus, fourth is a parallelogram, and fifth is a trapezium. Let us understand each in detail. Students, Let us see the first figure. First figure is a rectangle. In a rectangle, opposite sides are equal. As you can see, this is a figure of rectangle. You can see the sides which are marked in red, they are opposite sides. So these two are equal. The sides which are marked in blue, these are equal to each other. So opposite sides are equal to each other. And all the angles are 90 degrees. So does rectangle follows or satisfy all the criteria of being quadrilateral? Yes, it has four sides, it has four corners, and together, because all the angle is 90 degree, it has four corners. So again 19 to 4, so we'll be getting answer as 360. So it is satisfying all our criteria. That's why rectangle is one of the type of quadrilaterals. Next, students, we have another type of quadrilateral, that is square. Let us see with the diagram. If you can see, square has all sides equal, means all the four sides of the square will be equal to each other. All angles are 90. So students, here is square satisfying all the criteria? Yes, the lines or the edges are there, the corners are there, and together it is 360 degrees. So four edges, four corner, and 360 degrees. So this is why we can also call square is one of the type of quadrilateral. Square is a quadrilateral. Next figure, students. Now let us go towards rhombus. This is the figure of rhombus. This is how it looks. Now we'll understand how the rhombus works. Opposite sides are parallel to each other. So rhombus will be having opposite sides. So these two sides are parallel to each other. These two sides are parallel to each other of rhombus. All sides are equal. So you can see our conditions are getting satisfied. All sides are equal. That means it has four sides, four corners, and whenever you will be adding up the angles of rhombus together, it will be giving 360 degree. And that's the reason, because it is satisfying all our criteria, we can call rhombus is one of the type of quadrilaterals. Next figure, students, will understand parallelogram. How does the parallelogram is a quadrilateral? We can see, students, opposite sides are equal and parallel in parallelogram. As the name suggests, parallelogram, that means the opposite sides. You can see the sides are in blue, opposite sides are parallel to each other. You can see the sides are in red, opposite sides are equal and parallel to each other. Again, it is satisfying our criteria for quadrilaterals, four sides, four corner, and together, if you are adding up the interior angles, you will be getting 360 degrees, and that's why we can call even parallelogram a type of quadrilateral. The last type of quadrilaterals are trapezium. Students, this is how the trapezium look. You can see the figure. Now, let us understand what are the parts in trapezium. There are two sides are parallel to each other in trapezium. So you can see there are two sides which are marked in red. They are parallel to each other in trapezium. You can see trapezium is also satisfying a criteria. Four lines, four corners, and together when you will be adding all the angles of trapezium, it will be giving 360 degrees. And that's why these are five types of quadrilaterals in front of us: rectangle, square, rhombus, parallelogram, and trapezium. Now, students, let us understand in detail what is parallelogram. If the length of parallelogram is L and breadth is B, then the height will be considered as H. If someone is asking you what is the perimeter of parallelogram, then you will be answering is 2 multiplied by L plus B. L stands for length of parallelogram, B stands for breadth of parallelogram. So L plus B, whatever the answer, multiplied by 2 will be the perimeter of parallelogram. Students, you have to make sure that you have to memorize these formulas. like parallelogram, perimeter, parallelogram, area, there will be n number of formulas will be coming to you. So you just have to note it down and just have to memorize these formulas, because as per these formulas, the questions will be there in examinations to you. Now students, let us understand the area of parallelogram. The area of parallelogram is L into H, that is length into height. You can consider length into breadth also when needed, but mostly L into H or L into B will be the area of parallelogram. So students, now let us understand with the example. Example number one asks, find the area of parallelogram with the base of 12 centimeters and the height of 5 centimeters. Here in this figure you can see the base itself of parallelogram is 12 centimeters, means B is given in the question, H is also given in the question, and they are asking the area. As I have already told you, the area of parallelogram can be L into B also or B into H also, right? So you can just write A is equal to breadth into height, and because 12 is the breadth which is given in the question, we are just substituting the value 12 into 5, and then we will be getting 12 into 5, 60, the whole centimeter, that's why it is centimeter square. Students, you have to make sure you keep in mind centimeter square, these are the units, and if you are not going to write the units, you are giving a chance to the examiner to cut your marks. So please don't do that and make sure you use units everywhere. Now students, with this we'll be ending our lecture today. Thank you for being with us on Fun Known. Thank you.